If you ever wanted to live the van life, be able to just roam and go wherever you want, whenever you want, I'm gonna introduce you to somebody that's doing just that. We're hanging out today with Mike from Drawn There and the Vanlife app, checking out his super cool van and all of his cool art.
Van life is just living full-time out of a van. So we use the van like a house.
Okay. Yes,
right. I mean, it's our house. It's our home on wheels. And the beautiful thing is that we can go wherever we want, whenever we want.
Why not an RV, though? Like, why? This is obviously much smaller than an RV. Why did you guys decide to trick out a van?
For us, we picked this one because it's smaller. It fits in the normal parking space. We can move throughout cities. We can kind of maneuver into smaller spaces. One of the beautiful things is we can stand up inside.
How long have you guys been on the road?
So this spring will be 4 years. 4 years on the road.
What's the story behind going from kind of a traditional life,
right,
into, hey, let's trick out a van and drive around and quit our jobs,
like, yeah,
you know, or transition our jobs? That's a big change. What's the story behind that?
That we went to Burning Man 1 year in like 2015 or something. And it just kind of opened our eyes to some more alternative ways of living and alternative ways of just doing anything. You start to look at the decisions you're making. You're saying, like, well, why not do it this way or that way? And so we learned some things at Burning Man. And then the next year we wanted to go back, but we weren't able to get tickets. And so instead of going to Burning Man, we went to Wyoming. We were like, hey, we already have the week off from work. Let's go backpacking in Grand Tetons.
Nice.
And while we were there, we saw this van for sale on the side of the road. And it was all tricked out. It was beautiful, but it was like $120,000.
Right.
And we were like, well, that's just crazy. We can't afford that. But the whole week we were backpacking. We had like no cell phones, nothing else to talk about. We just like, well, what if we got a van? What if we built it ourselves? We save a lot of money. And what if we rent out our house and we can like use this as our new home? And so it all kind of snowballed. And within 30 days of seeing that first van, we bought our first van. And we spent the next 5 months building it out and making all of our arrangements, getting everything in order, and then we hit the road. So
you guys got into the van life because you drove past a van for sale.
Exactly.
On the side of the road,
yeah,
in Wyoming.
Yeah, and we said, you know,
I wonder where that van is now.
I don't know.
I wonder if it knows the impact that it made on you guys. What's the hardest thing about living in such a small space like this?
One of the big challenges is van life in the winter in a cold climate. You know, it's dark at 4 p.m., you're freezing. So one of the challenges is that, and then you just say, well, no, let's just go somewhere warm. Like, let's spend the winter in Arizona or Southern California. Some of the other challenges are where to park. That's kind of one of the biggest safety and like security kind of things. To go to bed at night and feel like you're not gonna get a knock on the window or you're okay to be there. It just means the world to have that kind of sense of security. And so in order to find that, we do use a lot of apps and we use a lot of technology. And one of the apps we use is something called the Vanlife app.
Yeah, you guys are a little invested in
yes,
that, aren't
we are,
you?
Yeah. So my wife has started this app and it's full of places to camp. It's like a online resource.
Have you guys had any scary experiences?
But there was one story of, we were in Texas. We had just left Big Bend National Park, which is right on the Mexican border. And we were driving west and it was getting late, and so we wanted to pull over for the night. And there was a spot where the two highways came together in a big gravel lot, and you could tell like truckers might sleep there or something.
Okay.
Like that. And there was a sign that said, you know, you're allowed to stay here 24 hours. And we were just getting settled in, a car pulled up behind us and we could hear it, and we heard their car door and we heard footsteps coming up towards us through the gravel. And I was like, okay, like, what's this about? Like, just let's see where this goes. And then we saw a flashlight coming through our front window. And I was like, okay, all right, so someone's here. And then we got a tap on the window. and I'm like leaning over the front seat, and I open up the door, and it's a Border Patrol agent. And he's like, hey, just wanted to check on you guys, make sure everything's all right. I said, yeah, we're doing fine. I was like, are we allowed to stay here, right? And he's like, yeah, you can stay. But I just want to let you know this is a big thoroughfare for smugglers, like coming out of Mexico or whatever. And I was like, I didn't even ask, smuggling what? I don't know if it's people or drugs or whatever it is.
Sure. Yeah.
And he was like, well, so if anyone else knocks on your window tonight, don't do what you just did. Don't open your door. Call 911 immediately.
Oh,
and
my God.
So it was one of those situations.
So did you stay the night or did you move
we
on?
We did stay. We stayed. Yeah.
Did you sleep well?
No, probably not. Yeah, right.
Let's ask some like kind of real basic questions here. Like, where do you take showers?
In the warmer weather, we can use a solar bag.
Okay.
It's just a 2-gallon bag. Put it on the roof for the day. It heats up to 90-some degrees, and then you shower out the back door.
And then how about, where do you do your business?
So we have a toilet in the van.
Okay.
We have a composting toilet, and it is beautiful. I mean, it's what makes the whole van feel like a home.
I have to know that you're gonna, whoever you're in the van with, you're gonna see every nook and cranny, you know, when all yes. There's not a lot of privacy.
At times, yeah, right. Yeah, although we do say, hey, time for you to take a walk, you know, that kind of stuff.
That's the secret. Right. That's the key to, I need a few minutes to myself.
Yeah.
How did you choose what goes in the van and what doesn't go in the van?
Yeah. I mean, so it's essentially an exercise in minimalism. And so you kind of take, in the physical aspect, you take all these things we had in the house and you have to pare it down. And it's like slowly. And you just end up cutting so many things out. Everything you have has two purposes.
So Mike, this is van number two.
This is, yes.
What happened to van number one?
But we were headed to Sun Valley, Idaho to meet some friends to go skiing. And we were driving through the night. It was like 9 p.m. and a herd of elk were running through the field.
Which are gigantic.
Yes, it was like four or five of them. One of them hit us on the side. And then we were doing like 60 miles an hour. One we hit head on and rolled up over the windshield.
Oh my
gosh. Over the front. And it was a disaster, and it totaled that van. It was such a wreck that
they're like 1,200 pounds or something gigantic.
He said, let's get another van. And so like, let's we're not done yet. There's still more to see. We haven't checked off all the boxes yet. So so now this is the second van. We bought this in Montana. It was a very lucky find. So we bought the van, and then we went back to Pennsylvania and rebuilt in a month. We were super ambitious.
Because you knew kind of the ins and the outs now. You'd done it already.
I learned so much from that first build. Now call this Van Haley.
Affectionately
named Van Haley after Haley, Idaho, where the old man
a little
died.
Play on Van Halen.
Yes, obviously, exactly. Too.
And now you have a gigantic bumper.
We've been working with this really cool company out of Arkansas, Backwoods Adventure Mods. They make the bumpers and the roof racks and all these really cool off-road gear.
Not only do you live this super cool van life, mm-hmm. but you're one of my favorite artists. You came over to the house,
right?
You rode your bike in the rain, I don't know, like 20 miles, and you drew the Joy Bus.
I did.
And the Joy Bus made the calendar, which is pretty rad. And I love this. This is actually up in my house. It's framed and all this. Tell me about your story of how did you become an artist?
So my previous career was as an architect, and I went to school for architecture, and I was working as an architect, and then I kind of was drifting into this other role of like project management. But I was losing touch with that artistic side and that creative producing side of why I got into architecture. On my 30th birthday, I said, all right, I need to like start something new. I want to put those past 30 years aside, and now looking forward, I want to like start a project. And so I got a sketchbook, and I was going to sketch once a day, every day for the next 30 years. So that's the goal. And right now I'm 7 years in. And the beautiful thing about living in a van and creating art on the road is that every day I'm somewhere new. Every day I can find something really cool and inspiring. And this was Mackinac Island. It's this really hot tourist spot, and there's a ferry that brings people over. So Mackinac Island has no cars. It's one of the last places in the country. No cars at all. Either you walk, ride a bike, or you have horse-drawn carriages.
Oh my gosh.
And so a lot of like these shops, like the FedEx deliveries come by horse and cart and like that kind of stuff. And so I'm sitting on a little stool on the sidewalk, and there's a storm drain, and it took me probably 45 minutes to realize the liquid flowing into that storm drain was horse urine. I thought it must have rained yesterday or something, but no.
So when you came over to the house and you were telling me you had this crazy idea.
Yes.
And what was the crazy idea?
You might think it's crazy. I thought it was perfectly normal. But I was going to ride my bicycle across the country. So from from New Jersey to California. And it was a dream I've had my entire life, and I did it this past summer.
But by yourself?
Yeah.
And you were self-supported, so you didn't have anybody following you around.
Yep.
And on your bike, you had, I mean, what did you carry on your bike?
Yeah, so it was just a normal road bike, and I had a couple bags on there, and I carried a tent, a sleeping pad, a sleeping bag, a couple change of clothes, my art supplies, obviously.
How far is it? How many miles did you do?
It's just over 3,000 miles, and I did, my average was about 115 a day, and it took me exactly a month. All of a sudden, on my very first day, I got a flat tire. I got a nail in my tire, and I was like, oh, well, this sucks, because it's gonna take me too long to change it. It's gonna be dark. And I looked around, I was like, well, I guess this is where I'm gonna sleep. So it was a cemetery, right in the middle of a town. It wasn't like I was just out, like, I was like, all right, well, I'll like go back to the very back corner of the cemetery where they keep the backhoe and all that kind of stuff. And I fixed my tire, and I was like, well, this is where I'm gonna be. And I was like, crouched behind some headstones. You know, I woke up at sunrise, and I went on my way, and it was all good. It's cool, I remember that last day, I woke up in Palm Springs, and I biked from Palm Springs. I didn't realize that Palm Springs is in a valley. Yes. I knew it was in a valley. I didn't know what kind of valley it was. And if you've been out there, you see all those wind turbines.
There's a reason.
Right, you know, the wind is going this way, and I'm going uphill against that wind. But then that final day was really cool, and I remember seeing the ocean for the first time. I had friends, and my wife was waiting for me.
All right, Mike, so let's get a tour of Van Haley, huh? So yeah. Tell me about this thing.
All right, so it's a 2017 4x4 Sprinter. It's on the 144-inch wheelbase. So that's the shorter wheelbase, but the tallest height.
Okay.
And it's because it's the 4x4, it gets lifted up a few inches. This was the old factory step right here. So we say, let's just skip that step, we'll go right inside. The interior is about 70 square feet of livable space. Okay. This is our refrigerator. It locks in place. If you ever forget to lock it, it's a disaster. You know, you hit your first stop sign and this thing comes sliding forward.
Cool. And this is all hooked up to your electricity and the solar, so this literally is always keeping things cold.
Over here, we've got the front seats. They both swivel around. So if we're parked somewhere for a couple days, swivel that seat around, it becomes the most comfortable spot in the van. This is a kind of a recent install, but it's really cool. It's a diesel heater. So it sips off the diesel tank and keeps this place warm at night.
I need one of those for the joy bus. Freezes in there in the middle of the night.
We built these cabinets. This is actually just a pergo flooring on the face there. Oh, it's kind of cool. A really cool material to work with. This is a very conscious decision was to put the snacks here. This is the snack drawer and the trash can. So while we're driving, Jess can just kind of reach back. She's like, oh, what do you want to eat? Grab a snack, and then you can open the trash from right there.
Snack.
And then we've got this cool hardware that makes sure nothing pops open when we drive.
So this is kind of like a boat would be then, right?
Exactly.
So the cabinets don't all slide open.
I installed a concrete countertop, which is not the most van-friendly thing for weight or anything like that. But again, we look at it like our house, and we wanted something that would be, you know, easy to clean, and it's durable, and I like working with concrete. It's really cool. I've built the form. You can kind of make it into whatever shape you want. We've got running water, runs on a 12-volt pump. These are our water tanks down here. So we're kind of lean on some systems. Sometimes, you know, our bumper says one thing and then our water tanks say the other. So we carry 12 gallons of fresh water. But what I like is I can just carry them out, take them to a store, fill them up anywhere I need to. I'm not always searching for a spigot or a hose. This is kind of cool. This is a stovetop oven. You know, cooking in a van certainly has its challenges, but we've done our best to, you know, if you ever want that pizza night kind of thing, you put all this stuff together. This is the bottom of that. And then the hot air comes up through the center, put the lid on, and now you can make your cakes, your muffins. Up here we've got some storage for toiletries, there's food. This is Jess's closet right back there. So again, talking about that minimalism wardrobe, she has more than two t-shirts. I only have two t-shirts, but you know, each bag is for a certain thing. It's shorts, pants, tops, whatever she needs. Everything gets its own bag. So it's a really cool way to organize your closet. We got a propane stove right here, two burner stove. More drawers with silverware and dishes all the way down to the bottom there. Over here is the one thing you really did want to see is the toilet. So this is the big moment. And right there is the composting toilet. So the secret in not giving away too much
on that kind of topic is that it separates the liquids and the solids. That's all I'll say about it, and that's the secret to how that works.
So well. You could use the bathroom and cook at the same time. That is a goal for me.
Well,
I'm not.
So, well, the funny thing is, like we take a lot of our work and calls from right here, and so you know, if you're on a Zoom call, you see from here up, and you don't know what's going on down below.
Yeah, that's true. Right.
This platform pulls out every night. And then there's another cushion back there. It goes right here. So now we sleep with our heads at the back door.
Okay.
And, you know, it's a little bit of maneuvering and some things like that. But it's one of the compromises you got to make on this.
Yeah.
These are window covers. We put them on every night. They're great for insulation and privacy. We've got window covers on the back. We can cover up every window. And so, you know, we pull into a parking space and nobody really knows we're in here. Along the way, we meet all these people and we exchange stickers. And then also this is our coat rack. So at night when we take our clothes off, we hang them all up here, let them air out.
Kind of cool when you build your own van, you get to make these decisions
right.
of what is most important to you. And so when we first built it, we said, all right, bikes are the most important thing. And so we made sure that the height of the bed would accommodate the bikes, and you start there and then you build out from that and kind of expand.
But this is what we call the garage. And sometimes it's funny, we'll be like laying in bed and we'll be like, oh, where's that thing? Oh, I think it's downstairs. You know, it's downstairs, I can't get it right now. But so we've got a inflatable stand-up paddleboard. We've got a burn box, which is all of our Burning Man costumes and equipment for Burning Man.
All right, so what's the crazy thing in the hitch?
All right, so in the hitch right here, we have our hammock mount. So this permanently mounts into our trailer hitch. And
this is for serious commitment of right. a hammock right here.
Yeah, I was like, I don't need to tow anything. I just need a place to relax. Just like that.
And then this is also when Jess is sick of you, she makes you ride in the hammock in the back.
Yeah, exactly.
Or this is sleeping on the couch. This is when you get kicked out. This is sleeping on the couch back here. So you guys have a penthouse in the Sprinter too. Yeah. So what's up there?
So up on the roof rack, we've got solar panels, three solar panels, and then just a deck, just a spot to hang around. And you're welcome to check it out.
I think I'm going to do some nude sunbathing real quick here. So let's go check it out. Well, I hope you guys love this episode, hanging out with Mike, with John there, getting the tour of his van, hearing about him riding his bike all the way across the US and all about his art. I know I've definitely enjoyed hanging out with Mike today. So I'm gonna go ahead and take a little nap if you guys wanna hang out. So thanks for watching this episode of Joy Bus Journeys. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe.